What's going on, everybody?
It's your boy Chris. Welcome back to Game Chat. Today we have a very special video following one of the most popular trends on the internet right now. We are doing NBA red flags. If you want potentially an MLB red flags or any other sport red flags, let us know. Drop it down a comment. I'll pass it over to Declan. He just wants to say a couple quick things.
Everywhere I go, I get papers. Everywhere I go, I get papers. I'm a rock star, I cut the joint slayer. Got the drum in the car, that bitch is slayer.
All right, before I start, pretty long hiatus. Honestly, I was a little busy.
I had my the last 2 weeks was super, super busy for both of us.
I think, personally, I think we should upload every Saturday. I think that should be a goal, every Saturday. And then sprinkle in some videos in there. Second, I've got three things. Okay. Second off, me and Chris both have the same mics. Everyone wish Chris happy birthday. Okay, number three, we need to talk about the Sam Gutierrez video. Okay, so I'm gonna go first with my first take, red flag or green flag, ready? If someone thinks MVP Rose is better than MVP Westbrook,
instant red flag.
I don't understand how someone can think that. I don't understand. And they're all given, like, I know Derrick Rose had suffered some, you know, had like three things wrong with his knee, four, whatever. So did Russ, bro. Russ had like two meniscus tears, bro, in his knee.
Yeah.
And he's back, bro. He's back.
Yep. So my first NBA red flag or green flag is Tyler Hero is going to lead the Heat in scoring next season.
I think that's a green flag. I'm good with that because honestly, like, Tyler Hero was balling in the preseason, and I actually have a take involving Tyler Hero. I do think he'll have to lead the Heat to get this. Green flag. I do. I think he'll average at
least. I'm just saying that adding 10 pounds of muscle, the slashing ability he added this offseason.
He's got a kid.
Yep.
And now he has to back up the claims that he's in the same category as Luka, Trey.
Exactly.
So, my next red flag or green flag, the Atlantic Division is the best division in basketball. So that would be the Celtics, Sixers, Knicks, Nets, Raptors.
I'm close to red flagging that if we're basing it off of last season, but I'm not going to.
You're going to green
flag. I was thinking that. I'm gonna green flag it. The Pacific Division is pretty nice if the Kings weren't shit.
Yeah.
If they were at least a 10 seed, it would be a different story, but
yeah, I agree. Yeah, they are literally so bad.
All right. So this one I might get a lot of hate for. Or a lot of love for. I don't know. Shout out Cleveland before I say this. Evan Mobley will be a top 5 center in the league at the end of next year. So not this season, but next.
Oh, and not this season.
Sorry. By the All-Star break of not this year, but the year after.
Ooh, I think he already is a top 20 center.
Yeah.
Center's not a deep position. I think he's top 20. I think by the end of next year, he can be anywhere from like 7 to 13. The problem is he's not going to get very much media attention because being on the Cavs. So I don't know how people deal with that. I think it's possible. I'm just going to red flag that. All right. So I think this might be the hottest, hot take of today. I've got Kobe is a top 3 player of all time.
Okay, bro, leave the Zoom call. That's a red. That's an instant red.
Bro, if you think Kobe's a top 3 player of all time, let alone top 5, that's a red flag, bro. I'm sorry. The highest I can see.
You lost your NBA card, okay?
The highest I can see is 8. He's not better than Tim Duncan. He's not better than Larry Bird. He's not better than Hakeem. Like, those are the only guys that possibly... He's not better than Shaq. He's not better than... I'm sorry. It's a red flag.
Borderline now he's better than Curry. Okay, so my next green flag or red flag is Ben Simmons, one of the hottest names in the NBA, is the most underrated player in the NBA right now.
Green flag. I don't understand the Ben Simmons slander. Just because he can't score at that elite level, he does everything else at an elite level. Top.
He can play every position. I guarantee you he could play every position, maybe except shooting guard at an all-star level.
All right. So, shout out to Alex and Evan for, giving me some ideas. Mo Bamba, Jordan Poole, and Tyler Hero will all be in the runnings for most improved player this year.
I'm gonna green flag it.
I agree.
Just because what I said about Tyler Hero earlier, you have a guy like Jordan Poole who's been absolutely terrific in the preseason and even towards the end of last season. And then you throw in a guy like Mo Bamba who's looking like he finally will at least be close to what we were told he could be.
Yeah. When I was watching the Magic, he was blocking everything, bro.
Yep. He looks bigger too. Like, he doesn't look like he's Slenderman anymore.
Well, I mean, when he had the little Jaylen Brown thing, it was a little sus. But
the flat top, I love the flat top on him.
He's got the straight thing going now, so.
Yeah. So my fourth take here, out of five takes, is Michael Porter Jr. will average 23 points per game and 7 rebounds, and the Denver Nuggets will make the NBA Finals and at least push a Game 6 against the Milwaukee Bucks.
So, if there was a yellow flag, I'm yellow flagging this easy. I just don't know whether I should green flag or red flag, because I partially agree. I think that Michael Porter Jr. will be in the runnings for most improved player. Everyone's been saying he's going to win it. I can do that, but here's the thing. I think he's going to be closer to like a 19, 20, and 7 guy. And
I'm green flagging that. Okay, I was just gonna remind you there that Jamal Murray is out for the first 5 months of the season too. Yep. So,
well, he's gonna have to step it up. This is my last take. In five years, a conversation about Giannis being top three will start to happen.
Let me just
top three
look.
All time, better than Kareem, better than Bill Russell.
Let me look up one thing before I make a comment here. All right, so you're saying when he's 31, this will be a discussion?
Yep. LeBron had that discussion when he was like really young, but like he won't be three at that time. But a conversation will be whether he can get to three.
He has so much time, you know, like,
yeah,
he could have another 15 years. Like, he could play till he's 41. Yeah. That's what Kareem did.
Yeah.
Does he have two MVPs?
He's got two.
A DPOY, a finals MVP, and then a
all NBA first teams galore. All defensive teams.
And didn't he win most improved?
Yep.
Oh, this is a really tough one. No, I'm red flagging it.
You're red flagging it?
I'm sorry. I just can't think of Giannis, especially with the competition he's going to have for those MVPs. Mm-hmm. I can't see him at least winning 5 MVP, because Kareem has 6 and 6 mm-hmm. championships.
Yeah.
That's going to be very, very hard for him to do.
Yeah. Where do you think he can end up?
I think he can end up either right behind Tim Duncan or ahead of Tim Duncan. There's no doubt in my mind he can pass Kobe, he can pass Wilt, and he can pass
Shaq. I think he's
Shaq.
On track to beat Shaq, Wilt, Kobe. I think that the lowest he can go now is 8. I think 8's the lowest he can go. Like he's on track to be at least.
Yes. So my final take here is the Boston Celtics will have the best record in the Eastern Conference this season.
I I'm gonna red flag that. I've got the Bucks, the Bulls. Bucks, the Bulls, at least above.
You're not gonna say the Nets?
I'm not gonna say the Nets.
They don't have Kyrie in the middle of that anymore. That's a way better.
I don't like the Nets, bro. I just, same with the Lakers. I don't think they fit well together. Like,
I think without Kyrie,
I don't know.
I think without Kyrie, the team fits so much better.
It fits better. If they can get a pass for a point guard,
they don't even need one. Harden can pass, like, he's a playmaker.
Yeah, but I'd look for, like, because who else would they have on?
Like Ricky Rubio, is that what you mean?
Like a Ricky Rubio, Rondo, like one of those type of guys.
And Jason Tatum, if this team is at least a 3-seed, Jason Tatum needs to be in the MVP conversation.
Do you think the Celtics, obviously the Celtics aren't better than the Bucks. Do you think they're better than the Bulls?
Yes. So that's going to wrap up today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let us know what you thought about our takes. Let us know about what you thought about the new intro. We're going to try to drop every Saturday, like Declan said, and peace out.